Good morning and welcome back to our new session on the Combining Security Association. In the previous sessions, we have seen what this security association is. In short form, we will call it as SCA. A security association is nothing but a logical connection. It is a logical connection that can be implemented between different hosts or between different end devices such as gateways or firewalls, or it can be a logical connection between a host and a firewall. So, there are different combinations where you can put this logical connection, and this logical connection is implemented for implementing various security services which are provided by the IPsec, like the various security services that are provided by the IPsec are the confidentiality, and another service is the authentication. We have already seen that the authentication can be provided by using this AH, that is authentication header, and the confidentiality will be provided by this ESP also, that is encapsulating security payload. One of the important advantage with this ESP is it provides both the confidentiality as well as the authentication. So, it is the user's choice to select whether the ESP has to provide the confidentiality service only, or it is going to provide both the confidentiality as well as the authentication. So, we have different these two types of security associations, that is one with the ESP and the other with the authentication header. One important point you should remember here is an individual security association, that means one security association can implement either the authentication or the confidentiality. That means either it can implement this authentication header or ESP. So, if you take one SA, either it can use this ESP or it can use this AH only, but it cannot use both the things at the same time. Until now we have seen this particular thing only, right. So, one security association will be providing or will be using this ESP, or it can be using, or it can use authentication header, but not both. But in real situation or in real life, you always require the combination of both these things. So, you should have a provision of providing both this authentication and confidentiality. Maybe the order of providing this authentication and confidentiality may vary. You can first provide the authentication and then provide the confidentiality, or in general we will be providing the confidentiality first, that means you will be using the encryption. So, you will be providing this confidentiality and then you will be using this authentication. So, the order is first encryption, and for the encrypted data, that is for the cipher text, you will be providing the authentication. The order can be in the reverse way also, that means first you will provide the authentication and then you will encrypt it. There are specific reasons why we make use of the encryption after the authentication, that we are going to discuss in the coming slides. So, sometimes as I told that a particular traffic flow will require all the services provided by both AH and ESP. This is where we require this combination of security association. And sometimes some traffic flow require IPsec services between hosts. Host means one system directly connected to another system. So, this is one case. Where you are going to provide the IPsec services between these two hosts. Or there is another case where you will be providing, assume that this host is connected to an internal network and it is having a gateway like this. And similarly, there is another host H2 which is present inside one network, and it is also having one gateway, and these two gateways are connected. In this case, you are going to provide the security between this gateway and the destination gateway. So, IPsec is being used to connect between or to provide the security services between these end devices, that is the gateways or the routers. And there can be another case also, where you will be having one host like this, and you are going to communicate with a host that is connected to a internal network through a gateway like this. In this case, you are going to provide the security from here to here, that means from host to gateway, and from this gateway to the destination host, you are going to provide some other type of security association. So, these are the various scenarios under which you can provide a security association. One is the security association between two hosts, and the case two is security association between two end devices such as the gateways or firewalls, and the third case is host and gateway, and then gateway and the destination host. Like that, there are different combinations which we will be discussing in the coming slides. So, you will have some different security association when you connect these direct hosts, and you will have to use different security association when you connect these two gateways, and similarly, this is another type of security association you are going to provide to connect a host and gateway, and then gateway to the destination host. So, in such situations, whenever you have a traffic flow which require both the authentication header and ESP, we are going to combine these two things, that is the authentication header and the ESP. That is the reason why the title is combining security association. So, one type of traffic flow that we use in the real life, they require both the AH and ESP, and the combination of this AH and ESP is termed as security association bundle. Very important terminology, and it is new terminology. Nothing important, nothing rocket science is there. It is nothing but a bundle of security associations. That means it is a combination of the security association. So, you can make use of AH and ESP, or ESP followed by AH, like that there are different combinations. So, this is the introduction to the combining the security association. We have started with the security association, what the security association is, and what services that the IP security is going to provide, and how we are going to achieve the authentication by making use of authentication header, and confidentiality and the authentication combinedly can be achieved by the ESP. And then we have seen that in some scenarios you require these both AH and ESP should be combined, and we have seen three different cases. This is all about the combining security association. That means, we have seen just why we require this combining security association. The reason is some of the traffic flow, they require them to be combined, both AH and ESP to be combined, and the term that we are using is the security association bundle. It refers to a sequence of security association, right. It can be a sequence or it can be a bundle also, nothing wrong in it. It refers to a sequence of security associations through which traffic must be processed to provide a desired set of IPsec services. So, you combine the security associations and you will be transmitting your data or traffic through these sequence or a series of security associations to have some greater level of IP security. And coming to our actual topic, as we have discussed that the security association may be combined in bundles in two ways. In the previous session, we have seen the two modes of operation of the ESP, where you have the transport mode and then you have the tunnel mode. So, the modes are the transport mode and then you have the tunnel mode. The same thing you should you can observe here, that the same thing is repeated here. That means whenever you want to bundle the security association, whenever you want to combine the security association, you have two things, that is the transport adjacency, which is almost similar to that of the transport mode which we have seen in the last session, and then we have this iterated tunneling. This is similar to that of the tunnel mode which we have seen in the last session. But let us see what is the difference between this transport adjacency and the iterated tunneling. You can see here that this is adjacency, that means the various security associations are kept side by side or in a series fashion, which provide the security in the with respect to the transport mode. So, this refers to applying more than one security protocol to the same IP packet without using the tunneling. So, you have different combinations of security associations, maybe one or maybe two combinations you can have, that means AH plus ESP or ESP plus AH. So, that combines AH and ESP, which allows for only one level of combination. This is very important. So, in the transport mode, you will be applying the ESP first, that is the encryption first, and then you will be applying the authentication. This is the sequence we are following. And this allows this security, the transport adjacency allows to have only one level of combination. Why it is allowing only one level of combination means, even though you put more number of combination, that means you are nesting the things, ESP plus AH inside ESP plus AH, everything is similar. It just increases the burden on the destination system. Why? Because every time you encrypt, the destination system has to decrypt it. So, the one of the disadvantages of the transport mode we have seen in the last session is the hosts are responsible to encrypt and decrypt the data. So, one level of encryption is enough, or one level of combination is enough here. So, if you put more and more levels of combinations like this, one ESP over another ESP and another ESP over ESP. Since everything, the decryption should be taken care by the destination system, the decryption burden will be present on the destination system. So, further nesting yields no added benefit, there is no added benefit for this encryption over encryption, encryption over encryption, right. But it has a disadvantage. If you do like this, you have a disadvantage that processing is performed at one IPsec instance, that is the destination. So, you will be putting lot of burden on the destination system. That is all about the transport adjacency. Remember that it is almost similar to that of a transport mode, where you will be providing the security to the IP payload. IP payload in the sense, it includes the TCP header and the data that is coming from the application. And coming to the second part, that is the iterated tunneling, the name itself is saying that we are going to make use of the tunneling mode, and it is iterated, that means you have more number of things to be iterated. So, you will be having more number of combinations. So, this iterated tunneling refers to the application of multi layers of security protocols effected through IP tunneling. So, you will be using the tunneling, that is what I told. Will be using the tunnel mode concept, but the advantage is you will be using multiple layers of security protocols, and this allows for multiple levels of nesting, since each tunnel can originate or terminate at different IPsec site along the path. The point here is, I will done, right? For example, you have host 1 here and you have another host here, H2, and they may be connected with different networks like this. Like this. So, I'm explaining about the tunnel mode and the two iterated tunneling. So, this is gateway 1, this is gateway 2, and this is gateway 3, and this is gateway 4. In the tunnel mode, we have the advantage that the decryption will be taken care by the gateways or the end devices. So, there is no burden that is put on this destination host H2. And you can have multiple levels of nesting where each tunnel can originate. For example, you can have one type of tunnel from G1 to G2, and you can have another type of tunnel from G1 to G3, or you can have another tunnel from G2 to G3, G3 to G4. Like that, you can have different types of tunnels, you can arrange it. That is the reason why the iterated tunneling allows us to have different tunnels which originate at different points and which terminate at different points along the path. But most of the cases you will be originating the tunnel at the sender gateway, and the tunnel may end at any gateway within the path. That is what the author is saying. So, you have different gateways that are connected or that lies in between the source host and the destination host, and you can have different types of tunnels that can terminate at any point within the path. But that does not happen in transport mode. Why? Because the transport mode, as we have seen, that it is between two different hosts. This is the host 1 and this is host 2, like this. And the security association is from end to end, that means from host 1 to host 2, end to end encryption or end to end security will be provided in the transport mode. So, though you provide lot of nesting, that is not at all useful, and rather than you are burdening the destination system. These are the two security associations that we have that can be used to bundle the things. That one is the transport adjacency and the other one is the iterated tunneling. Once we are clear about these two approaches, now our intention is to combine these things. So, the two approaches can be combined. For example, you can have a transport security association. This is, assume that this is transport security association, and you can have, this can be combined with another tunnel association, another tunnel security association. Like the this tunneling, remember that one important term, that whenever you use tunneling, you should be very careful that tunneling is between two different gateways or two different end devices. Whenever you use the transport security association, this is between two hosts, this is between two gateways or firewalls. So, keeping this in mind, you should be very careful that when you speak about the transport security association, that should be between the hosts, and when you speak about the tunnel security association, that should be between the gateways. So, you can combine this transport security association, that is between two hosts that travel a part of way through the tunnel security association between the security gateways. We will see with examples also, do not worry, right. But important point you should remember, one important point that you should remember is that the transport level security association is between two hosts, and the tunnel level association, security association, is between two gateways. Very important point you should understand. And another interesting point regarding this ESP and AH is whether you are going to consider the security bundles in the order in which authentication and encryption should happen. So when you consider the security association, whether you are providing the ESP, that is the confidentiality first, and then you are providing the authentication, or whether you are providing the authentication first and then you are providing the encryption later. This is what one interesting story we have. Most of the things, in most of the cases, you will consider the encryption first and then you will consider the authentication later. But sometimes you require the authentication first and then the encryption later. There are few advantages of having this authentication first rather than this encryption. We will see them with few examples also. This is what I am telling, right? Encryption and authentication can be combined in order to transmit an IP packet that has both confidentiality and authentication between the hosts. That means you can provide the confidentiality first and whatever ciphertext you get, you can authenticate it, or else you can first authenticate the IP packet and then you provide or you convert it into the ciphertext. There are different approaches, but the important thing you have to remember is the authentication and confidentiality are the two important services that the IPsec is going to provide to us. For this we have several approaches. There are three different approaches, perhaps it's not several. One is the ESP with authentication option. We know this very well, right? The main purpose of this ESP, encapsulating security payload, is itself to provide the confidentiality as the primary security service. But it, in addition to this confidentiality, we can also choose, we means the author or the user can also choose the authentication option also. So ESP is going to provide both the confidentiality and authentication. And the second approach we have is the transport adjacency. This we have seen in the earlier slide also. We are going to provide the IPsec services in between the hosts, then only we will make use of this transport adjacency. And important point you should remember about this transport adjacency is that we are not going to nest different levels. Why? Because it is waste of time, or it does not have any influence by making use of different levels of transport adjacency. And the third approach what we have is the transport tunnel bundle, very important concept. We are going to combine the transport as well as the tunnel also. We will see all these things. Let us go with the ESP, the first approach, that is the ESP with the authentication option. This approach we have already seen in the previous session, where we have two different modes, that is the transport mode and the tunnel mode. That means the ESP is going to be used to provide this type of confidentiality and the authentication service. So the user first applies the ESP, I'm discussing about this one. So the user is going to apply the ESP to the data, that means first he is going to provide the confidentiality service, and for the thing that we get here, that means the ciphertext. For the ciphertext, we are going to make use of the authentication service, or we are going to append the authentication data field, right? We have seen this one, right? We have this TCP header, and then we have the application data. So for ESP, you will be using the ESP header, and then you have this ESP trailer also. First, you will apply the confidentiality from TCP header followed by data plus ESP trailer, this everything is encrypted to ciphertext. And when you require the authentication, you will optionally add this authentication header at the end of the ESP trailer. So, authentication will be from here to here. This is a very important concept you should understand. And the two different modes, that is the transport mode and the tunnel mode, we have seen. So, in the transport mode ESP, we know that authentication and encryption apply to the IP payload only. IP payload in the sense it is a combination of TCP and the application data. So, above this we have IP header. This we know. The entire thing is called as IP packet. But IP payload stands for this TCP plus data. So, in the transport mode, the authentication and encryption are being applied to the IP payload that is delivered to the host, but the IP header is not protected in this transport mode. This we have seen it clearly in the last session. And what about the tunnel mode? The tunnel mode, we are going to provide the authentication to the entire IP packet delivered to the IP destination address. That is when you are going to deliver the outer IP packet up to the firewall or up to the end device or the gateway. And authentication is performed at the destination. So, the entire inner IP packet is protected by the privacy mechanism for delivery to the inner IP destination. So, this also we have seen. So, in the tunnel mode, you have this TCP followed by data, and then we have this IP header. This is very important. And above this we are going to use the ESP header, and here we have this ESP trailer. So, from here to here you will be encrypting. So, you are encrypting the IP header also, and when you require some additional authentication you will add this authentication, and from here to here you will have this. This is encryption and this is authentication. In order to have the best route or the routing information to be placed in the IP packet, you will be adding some additional IP header. This is the new IP header, very important. This is all about the tunnel mode, and this is the transport mode. This particular approach we have seen in the earlier session. We have just gone through the topic thoroughly. So, this is all about the ESP with authentication option. In this approach, the user first applies the ESP to the data to be protected and then appends the authentication data field. This is what we seen. So, we have two sub cases. One is the transport mode ESP and the second one is the tunnel mode ESP. In the transport mode ESP, the authentication and encryption is going to be applied for the IP payload which is delivered to the host, but the IP header is not protected. But in the tunnel mode, the authentication applies to the entire IP packet delivered to the outer IP destination address, which is nothing but the firewall. And the entire inner IP packet is protected by the privacy mechanism for delivery to the inner IP destination. So, in both the cases, authentication applies to the ciphertext. This is very important. So, first you are going to encrypt the data, and for the resultant ciphertext you are going to apply the authentication. So, this is the order, is the encryption first and then the authentication later. This is very important. And coming to the next approach, what we have is the transport adjacency. We have already studied this transport adjacency. So, this is another way to apply the authentication after encryption, very important. So, in the previous approach, that is the ESP with authentication option and the transport adjacency, you are going to provide the encryption first and then you are going to authenticate the entire thing. So, this is another way to apply the authentication after encryption, and that is by making use of two bundled transport security associations. So, you are going to bundle the two transport security associations. Remember, that means you have one security association like this and the outer will be having another security association. This is called as the inner security association and this is called as the outer security association. So in the inner security association, this is the going to implement the ESP. And the outer association is going to be used with the authentication header. In this case, you should observe that the ESP exclusively takes care of confidentiality only. It is used, the ESP is used to provide the ciphertext only. It is not going to provide the authentication header. So you are not going to check or select the option of authentication while using this ESP. And since it is a transport mode, you can observe here that the encryption is applied to IP payload only. That means you are going to apply the encryption for the TCP header plus the application data. This is called as IP payload. Since the ESP what you are choosing for the inner security association is not selected with the authentication, the outer layer, the outer security association, you are going to make use of the authentication header to provide the authentication. So initially you will be having the encryption and then you will be having the authentication. This you should observe. So AH is then applied in the transport mode so that the authentication covers the ESP plus the original IP header. Right. So in this case, initially let us see with the ESP. We have this TCP followed by data, and when you apply this ESP, you will have this ESP header. And then you have the ESP trailer, but here you are not going to use the authentication data. Why? Because the inner ESP we are not going to make use of the authentication. The option is not selected. So the IP header will be preceded with the ESP header. And in the second association, you can see here that the authentication header is used. Therefore, the entire IP packet from here, that is IP header to the ESP trailer, you are making use of the authentication. We are going to make use of the authentication. So you can observe here that the authentication covers the ESP packet, that is from here to here, plus the IP header also. This is the advantage we have. So the advantage of this approach is it is more simple using a single ESP SA for both ESP authentication option is that authentication covers more fields here. If you are going to use the ESP with confidentiality and authentication header, the authentication is provided from this TCP to the ESP trailer only. But in this approach, you are putting the authentication header layer above this ESP. So in this case, you are going to provide this authentication header, or the authentication is provided for more fields. That means you are going to provide the authentication for ESP header and you are going to provide the authentication for the IP header also. This is very important. That is the advantage we have with this transport adjacency, where we are making use of two different security association. The inner security association is using the ESP without the authentication option, and the outer security association is going to use the authentication header. The advantage is authentication covers more fields, including the source and destination IP addresses. That is nothing but the IP header plus ESP header. But the disadvantage is it is having the overhead of processing two security association rather than one security association. So one security association processing will be less when compared to that of processing the two security association. This is the disadvantage we have. Other than this, the advantages we have from this transport adjacency are more. And the next approach what we are going to discuss is the transport tunnel bundle. So you are going to combine two different mechanisms or two different modes, that is the transport as well as the tunnel. And one important point you have to remember here is this is different from the two different from the above two approaches. In the above two approaches, you remember that you are providing the encryption first and then you are providing the authentication later. But in this approach, that is the transport and tunnel bundle, you are going to provide the authentication first and then you are going to provide the encryption. So, this is something different you have, this transport and tunnel one, very important. So, the use of this transport tunnel bundle is we are going to use the authentication prior to encryption. We have different reasons. Here the author is going to discuss about only two reasons why we are going to provide the authentication first and then the encryption later. So, the first reason is if you have the authentication data provided protected by the encryption, it is impossible for anyone to intercept the authentication data. So, the attacker cannot modify the authentication data. Previously, what is the disadvantage is you have this TCP data and you have this data and then you have this ESP header and ESP trailer. So, from here to here you are going to encrypt it. And from here to here you are going to authenticate and then you are going to add it like this. And you can observe here that the authentication data that you are putting at the end of the ESP trailer, this is not encrypted. Whenever it is not encrypted, it is not safe. Whenever it is not safe, there are lot of possibilities that the end user or there are lot of possibilities that the attacker can attack the system and he can just crack it or he can just get the authentication data or he can modify the authentication data. So, in order to protect the authentication data, you should be very careful that this authentication data can be encrypted. So, when you encrypt the authentication data, the attacker cannot modify or cannot get any idea about this authentication data. So, the first reason why we are choosing the authentication prior to encryption is in order to protect the authentication data from the unauthorized users. So, the attackers cannot intercept the message and they cannot alter the authentication data without this thing. And the second reason is it is very simple, right? Sometimes the destination system requires the authentication data to be stored. So, this storage purpose is for later reference. So, authentication data when it reaches the destination system like this, this is the source and this is destination. When it reaches, when the packet reaches the destination system, there are sometimes there are possibilities that the authentication data should be stored in the database that is located at the destination for later references. And for this purpose, for the storage purpose, this is for storage. So, for the storage purpose, it is convenient that you make use of this authentication information applies to the unencrypted message. Otherwise, the message would have to be re-encrypted and you have to verify the authentication information. So, once you do this decryption, see here at the source you are first adding the authentication data and then decrypting it, encrypting it. And at the destination side it should be the reverse process. So, you first decrypt it and then you use the authentication data. So, once at the destination end you decrypt it, the authentication data is readily available and you can store it in the database that is present at the destination. So in order to have the more security and in order to store the authentication data for later references, it is better that you choose the authentication prior to encryption. Then that is possible. The authentication prior to encryption is possible only in case of transport and tunnel bundle. This is one of the approach. So these are the three different approaches we have seen for providing the authentication plus confidentiality services. And we are left with only one topic of discussion in this particular concept of combining different security associations, that is the basic combinations of security associations. We have four different cases that need to be discussed here, and everything we have discussed earlier itself, but here we are going to explain it diagrammatically. We will show the diagram and we will check what is there inside it, right. So the IPsec architecture document, whatever we have in the RFC, that is going to explain about four examples of combinations of security association that must be supported by the IPsec hosts. In the sense, it can be a workstation or it can be a server, and the security gateways also. Gateways means it can be a firewall or router. So whatever document we have, that is the RFC document that explains the IPsec architecture, it is going to explain us, or it is going to give the information related to the combination of security associations that must be supported by this IP host, such as workstation or server, or the security gateway such as firewall or router. So the IPsec architecture document lists out these four examples of combinations where the systems or the hosts like workstation and server should be compliant, or similarly the security gateways like firewall and router should be compliant, right. So in the coming slides, whatever diagrams we show, it consists of two different parts, the lower part and the upper part. The lower part in each case or in each figure represents the physical connectivity, and the upper part represents the logical connectivity, which is nothing but SA. So that SA can be either one or more nested SAs also. You can have more number of security associations, and each SA can be either AH or ESP. That is the thing you have to understand, and we are going to concentrate about the upper part only. Why? Because our topic of interest is towards the security association. So the upper part represents the security association and nesting of the security association. That is the reason why we just concentrate on the upper part. We are not bothered about the physical connectivity of these elements. And remember that when we discuss about the security association, each security association can have either AH or ESP. For host to host security association, the mode can be either transport or tunnel, otherwise it must be tunnel mode. So from host to host, we know that you can make use of the transport mode. And from gateway to gateway, you can make use of the tunnel mode. These everything we have discussed in the previous discussions only, right. So this is case one. You can see here, as I told that each and every diagram is divided into two parts. This is the lower part, which represents the physical connectivity, and this is the upper part, which represents the SES or the logical connectivity. So you can see here that these are the two hosts that wants to communicate with each other, and you can observe here that the source host is connected to a local intranet and the end device is this router 1. and the second host H2. Let us say that this is H1 and this is H2. This H2 is also connected to a local intranet, and the router we have, the end device we have, is the router 2. And this router and router are connected via internet. This is a simple case we have. And here you can see this upper layer, this is our topic of interest. You can have one or more security associations. You can see here that the inner circle is one SA and the outer tube is another SA. This is just for our understanding purpose. So, here we are combining two security associations. You can have more number of security associations also, like this. You can put one more layer here and you can put another. So, the case one is to provide the security between end systems that implement IPsec. So, end systems in the sense host 1 and host 2. Whenever you talk about the providing security to the end systems or the hosts, the mode you are going to use is the transport mode. So, whenever you want to make secure the communication between the end devices or the host that implement IPsec via these SAs, different combination of SAs, they must share the appropriate secret keys. Right? That is a different case which we are going to discuss in terms of IKE, which is the next topic of our discussion. So, among these possible combinations, we can have the AH in transport mode. Why we are saying it as transport mode means we have to provide the security between the hosts. So, host means it is related to transport mode. So, in transport mode you can use only authentication option, therefore, AH in transport mode can be used, or you can use the confidentiality via this ESP and that can be used as ESP in transport mode. And the third option we have is ESP followed by AH, and that too in transport mode only. This is nothing but ESP security association inside AH security association. So, you can see here this is ESP, the inner one is ESP and the outer one is AH. This we have seen in the previous discussions also, that is nothing but the transport adjacency. And this is not the all the case, right? Transport, this is all about the transport mode security. AH can be used, ESP can be used, or ESP followed by AH can be used. And the last case, this is an extraordinary case we have, that is you can make use of the tunnel mode also. So, you can have any one of these above, that is AH in transport mode, ESP in transport mode, ESP in transport mode and ESP followed by AH, everything can be combined, but you can make use of the tunnel mode also. This is something extra we are going to learn, but maximum you remember the term that when you are going to provide the security association between the hosts, it will be through the transport mode only. But additionally, what we have learned here is, in addition to the transport mode, we can also make use of the tunnel mode, though tunnel mode is exclusively related to providing the security services between the end devices such as the routers and gateways. We can also provide it, we can also make use of it to provide the security between the hosts also, right. And coming to the second case, which is very simple thing, you can see here that the same diagram we are using, the host 1 is connected to the local internet via this gateway and host 2 is connected to the internet via this local intranet via this security gateway. And you can see here that we are providing a security association between the gateways. When we make use of the security association between the gateways, you know very well that you have to use the tunnel security association. So here the security is provided only between the gateways, that is the routers or firewalls, etc., and no hosts implement the IPsec. So there is no security provided from here to here and from here to here, no security. So this case illustrates a simple virtual private network that is implemented by different organizations. So virtual private networks will be implemented in this way, where you have the security between these two gateways, not between the gateway and the host. The security architecture document specifies that only a single tunnel security association is needed for this case. One tunnel association is enough, nothing more than that. So the tunnel could support, this tunnel could support either AH or ESP or ESP with AH option. Here the reason why we require only one tunnel SA, why we are not using the nested tunneling means, the reason is the IPsec services apply to the entire IP packet. So whenever you use the tunnel mode SA, you have to remember this particular thing, right? TCP followed by data, and then you have the IP packet. It is in tunnel mode, IP header, and then you have the ESP like this. So this IP header is protected by this ESP. It is encrypted, it is converted into the ciphertext by this ESP. Therefore, there is no need for nesting of this tunnel mode security associations. One more important point. And coming to the third case, this is an extension, or you can say that it is a combination of case 1 and case 2. You can see here that the gateways are having the tunnel mode SA, this one, and the end host systems are connected via 1 or 2 SAs. So this is case 1 we have seen, and this is case 2 we have seen. So it is a combination of both case 1 and case 2, where you are going to provide the tunnel security association between these gateways and one or more combinations of security associations between the hosts. So what happens here? The gateway to gateway tunnel provides the authentication and confidentiality, or both, for the traffic that lies between the end systems, that is the hosts. And when the gateway to gateway tunnel in ESP, it also provides a limited form of traffic confidentiality. So from individual hosts can implement any additional IPsec services required for given application, or by users by means of end-to-end SAs. Initially you have lot of security with this tunnel mode, but if the end systems wants to provide some additional security, they can make use of this particular scenario, where they can make use of one or two security association between the hosts. This is more secured. Tunnel security association is itself secured, but in addition to it, the users have opted to select this selection of using this one or two SAs between the hosts. So more secured. And the last case what we are going to discuss is this one. So this is a different scenario, where you have a host that is connected to the internet. In the last session also we have taken the same example. One host connected to internet, and it is going to connect to another host H2 that is located as one of the hosts inside the local intranet, and that is connected, the local internet is connected to this security gateway. In such case, you can apply the security association, that is the tunnel mode security association is applied from this host to this gateway, from here to here. And from host to host, as we can see that this inner these two, you can have one or two security association. And this case provides support for a remote host that uses the internet to reach an organization's firewall. So, this host that is connected to the internet, it wants to reach a host that is present as one of the system of the organization. It wants to go through this firewall, organization's firewall, and it wants to gain the access to this server or workstation behind the firewall, which is present behind the firewall. In such case, you can make use of this particular combination. A very simple concept we have, these four combinations. Let us have a quick recap. The first case is to provide the security between the end system, therefore, they can make use of the transport mode, where you can use one or more security associations. The inner security association will be providing the ESP and the outer security association will be providing the AH. And the second case is where you are going to provide the IPsec services between the gateways. So, you are going to use only the tunnel SA. One tunnel SA is enough. Why? Because you are protecting this IP header when you use the tunnel mode SA, and there is no need for the nesting here. And the third case is a combination of case 1 and case 2, where you will be providing or where you will be securing the gateways by making use of tunnel SA, and the end to end host systems are secured by making use of 1 or 2 SAs as in case 1. And the last case is a different scenario where a host that is connected to the internet wants to access a server or workstation which is present behind the firewalls of an organization. In such case, the host and gateway can implement the tunnel mode security association, and the host 1 and host 2 behind the firewall of the organization can make use of 1 or 2 security associations. So, in this session we have this, that's all about the basic combinations of security association. In this session we have started our discussion with the IPsec services and how we can combine the IPsec services, what is the reason for combining these IPsec services, what are the two associations or bundles we have, that is the transport adjacency and the iterated tunneling. The transport adjacency does not allow nesting, but the iterated tunneling allows nesting. And then we have moved our discussion through this authentication plus confidential, that is very important. Whether you are going to provide the confidentiality prior to authentication or authentication prior to confidentiality, most of the cases will be providing the confidentiality prior to authentication. So, we have two different approaches for it. One is the ESP with authentication option, and the second one is transport adjacency. Both these approaches, they are going to provide the encryption prior to authentication. But the third approach what we have discussed is the transport tunnel bundle, which is going to provide this one, which is going to provide the authentication prior to encryption. There are different reasons. One is for getting the safe authentication data at the destination, and the second reason is to store the authentication data before decrypting it. So, after this we have moved our discussion to the basic combination of security associations, where we have seen four different cases where you are providing the security between two hosts, security between two gateways, security between gateways as well as the hosts, and the security between a host and a host that is present beyond or behind the firewall of an organization. So, that's all for today's session. This is end of the topic, the combining security association, and this completes the entire discussion on the encryption followed by the authentication, like the ESP. So, ESP we have completely seen, and in coming sessions I am planning to discuss about one more service that is provided by the IPsec, that is the internet key exchange. It's a very simple topic which requires, and you will be coming across lot of terminology also. So, We'll discuss everything in the coming sessions about this IKE, Internet Key Exchange. Let us wrap up today's session. Thank you one and all for joining the session.